Hello students, in this video I'll explain the geometrical isomerism. Those you are not subscribed RD chemistry, please do subscribe, like the videos and share the videos. Now the geometrical isomerism is also called as the cis-trans isomerism. It is also called as the cis-trans isomerism. Cis-trans isomerism. Okay. Now we are going to study geometrical isomerism for two types of compounds. One is square planar complexes, okay, and other one is the octahedral complexes, Now let me draw the geometry of the square planar. Now when I say square planar geometry, central metal atom is in the center, correct? Then there should be four ligands around it. Okay, let me call the ligands as capital letter L. First ligand, second ligand, third ligand, and the fourth ligand. Okay, now when I join the corners of these ligands, what I'll get? I'll get a square shape. Therefore, such a geometry is called as the square planar geometry. Now, let me number the corners of the square like 1, 2, 3. And 4, correct? Now I want to explain what is the cis and trans positions. Cis and trans position. The immediate neighbors are always cis positions. Opposite ends are always the trans position. 1, 2 positions are cis, or 2, 3 are cis, or 3 and 4 cis, or 1 and 4 are cis. All these are cis positions. 1, 2 position, neighborings are always a cis position. Okay. Now what is trans position? Now we see 1 and 3, they are on the opposite ends. Similarly, 2 and 4 are the opposite ends. They are the trans positions. Okay. They are the trans position. So we are going to study under geometrical isomerism two isomers for the same compound. One is the cis isomer, other one is the trans isomer. Right. Now let me draw octahedral geometry. Okay, central metal atom is in the center, correct? Then there are four ligands around the central metal atom which form the square shape, okay? So let me write the ligands as 1, 2, 3, and 4 ligands, correct? This is like a book. Assume this is a square book. Above the square book, let me place one more ligand just above it. And below that, let me place one more ligand. Okay. So there are four corners of the book. Above the book, I'll keep one ligand and below it one ligand. But they are connected to what? They are connected to the central metal atom. One is above the plane, other one is below the plane. Correct? Now what I can do is, I can join the corners of these, right? Here, I'll join the corners of these ligands. What you can see here, we can see a triangular which forms one face of the octahedra, correct? So now how many faces are possible altogether? It will form one face. So I can have, how many corners are there above the plane? Four corners are there. Therefore I can form four triangular faces. And below also, how many faces can be drawn? Again, four faces can be drawn. That's why the name comes. Okay. So four triangular faces above the plane plus four triangular faces below the plane. Altogether we can have eight faces. Therefore, it is called as the octahedral geometry. Octahedral. Octa stands for eight. Okay. Now I'll give the number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay. Now I'll write what are the cis positions. Immediate positions are cis position. 2 and 3 are cis. Correct. 3 and 4 are the cis. 4 and 5 are the cis. Right. 2 and 5 are also the cis. Also, with respect to 1, 1, 5 positions. 1, 2 positions. 1, 4 positions. 1, 3 positions are all cis. Now what is trans? Similarly, 6 to 1, 6 and 4, 6 and 3, 6 and 2, 6 and 5 this is position. What is the trans position here? Trans is opposite ends. 1 and 6 are trans. 2 and 4 are trans. 5 and 3 are trans. All these are trans. Okay. So we have got cis geometry and trans geometry. Now let me take some examples. Then we'll draw the cis isomer and trans isomer for the same compound. Okay. Clear? Let me take one square planar complex. That is a platinum complex. PT. Platinum is the center metal atom. Amine ligand NH3 2 times and chlorido 2 times. Altogether 4 ligands are there. Therefore, coordination number is equal to 4. What is coordination number? Number of donor atom directly attached to the central metal atom. Okay. This complex in general, write it as the M, central metal atom, X2, like amine ligand in general. One more ligand, let it be L2. This is the general formula of the square planar complex involving altogether 4 unidentate ligands. Now, I'll write a cis and trans. So, I'll write me write on PT. Then, there are 4 corners in the square shape, correct? So, next one, PT. 4 corners in the square, correct? Let me write on first one, this is geometry. Other one is the trans geometry, okay? Now, here, CLs, okay, are repeating 2 times. I'll write them together, okay? So, CLs are together. Here, amine ligands are together. Amine ligands are together, correct? So, they are 1-2 positions, okay? Immediate position, neighborings, okay? So, this is the cis geometry. This is known as the cis geometry. I can join the corners also. Now, we'll write down the trans geometry. Let me take a CL here. Another CL right on the opposite side. Okay. Then amine are on the opposite sides. When they are on the opposite side, that geometry is called as the trans geometry. Okay. If the ligand, similar ligands are together on the same side, they are the cis. If they are on the opposite side, they are the trans. Clear? Right? Yeah. Now let me take the example of the octahedral complex. Okay. Let me take a CO, cobalt, amine, NH3, repeated 4 times, then chlorido ligand 2 times, okay, and the overall charge for this complex is a +1 charge. Now, altogether, how many donor atoms are there? Nitrogen has got here, altogether 4 nitrogen atoms, 2 Cl, okay, so what is the coordination number? Coordination number is 6. When the coordination number is 6, it is a octahedral complex, 6 ligands are there. General formula, what is the general formula? M, okay? Then X 4 times I can write if for this example, right? And one more ligand repeated 2 times. This is the general formula, okay? Altogether, how many ligands are there? 6 ligands are there, assuming X and L are the unidentate ligands. So I want to write on cis geometry and the trans geometry, okay? First, what I'll do, I'll draw the skeleton of the octahedral, cobalt in the center, then 4 ligands are there in the same plane. Okay. So, they form the square planar geometry. They form the square planar geometry. Okay. Right. And one is the above the plane. Other one is the below the plane. Clear? Similarly, for the trans geometry also, let me draw the skeleton first. Okay. 4 ligands are there in the same plane. 4 are there in the same plane. And one is the above the plane. Other one is the below the plane. To give the octahedral shape, right? Clear? Now, how to write down cis and trans, okay? With respect to which ligand I should write down cis and trans? Here, there is a ligand which has got, which is repeated only 2 times. You have to look for that ligand which is repeated 2 times in this case. That is a Cl repeated 2 times. So, with respect to Cl, write down cis and trans. So, I'll start with the trans first. Let me write on Cl, above the plane, let me write on Cl, below the plane. With respect to Cl, it is a trans. Remember student, with respect to Cl, it is a trans. You have to always look for that ligand which is repeated 2 times. Okay, right? Now, remaining we can write amine ligand. Okay, amine ligand. Amine ligand. See to that, nitrogen atom is bonded to the cobalt, because nitrogen is a donor atom here. So, this is the trans with respect to what? Cl. Now, what I'll do? I'll keep the CL same position. Next, I'll draw one trigon cis form. Therefore, I'll write this position here. Okay, CL is fixed. And these two positions are the cis to each other. Then remaining write down, okay, in the available corners. So amine ligands are repeating. Got it? Amine ligands. Correct? Yeah. And we need not show the face, the trigonal face we did not show here. Okay. So with respect to CL, it is a cis position. With respect to trans, okay, here, with respect to CL, trans positions are there. Clear? Right? Okay. So let's move on to the next example. Now let me take one more octahedral complex which involves a didentate ligand. Cobalt, CO, central metal atom, then chlorido, two times repeating, then EN, EN stands for ethane 1,2 diamine. Correct? Now what I'll do, I'll write a general formula. Central metal atom M, then one of the ligand repeating two times, then there's a didentate ligand, EN, you know that, correct? Didentate ligand. How many donor atoms are there per molecule? Two donor atoms. Repeat how many times? Two times. Now see here, okay? So, first donor, second donor in the didentate. Two are done. Two into two. Two into two, how much? Four. Four plus two, six. So, the coordination number is six. That means octahedral shape. I will draw the skeleton first, okay? Then we'll write down the ligands in the cis position and the trans positions. Now with respect to which ligand we'll write down the cis and trans, CL. In this case, CL repeated two times, but in EN, how many altogether repeated? Altogether 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are there. Okay. So nitrogen atom in EN repeated altogether 6 times. So you have to look for the chlorido ligand which is repeated two times. So with respect to CL, we have cis and trans. So I'll write on the trans first. Okay. So CL above the plane. CL below the plane. Okay. Then remaining are EN. EN I'll write like this. Okay. I'll not write on the actual formula. EN. Short form I'll write down. Didentate ligand, which can form two bonds. So I write like this. Okay. Which can form two bonds. Again, this side EN. Okay. Repeated. Okay. Two bonds are there. Each EN can form two bonds. So this is a way of writing the EN structure. Now I'll write on the cis form. CL is fixed here. One more CL here. Not on the opposite side. Then remaining EN. EN. One EN can form two bonds. There are two donor atoms. So we write like this. Okay. One more EN which can form two bonds because a didentate ligand. So this is a cis and this is a trans of the given octahedral complex. Clear? We have one special type of the octahedral complex for cis and trans. It is a MA3B3 type. That means a ligand repeated three times and one more ligand also repeating three times. MA3B3 type. This is amine ligand. This is a nitrito ligand. Okay, a special type. So let me draw the skeleton first. Okay. So we have got CO, central metal atom. Then there are four ligands like this, correct? Okay. So we have got square planar shape with respect to four ligands, right? Now, one is above the plane, other one is the below the plane. Now, what I'll do, I'm going to draw a triangular face, okay? So, this is a trigonal face, one trigonal face. One is there. How many are there altogether trigonal faces? Altogether eight are there. That's why the name comes octa. I'll draw only one. Now, what I'll do, these are the corners. Adjacent positions, adjacent corners for the triangular face. Now here I'll keep the same ligand like NH3, 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 correct? So similar ligands or similar donor atoms forming one face of the octahedral. Okay, so remaining I'll write it here, NO2, NO2 and NO2. These also form one face. I'll not draw that face. But see here, NH3 can form one face of the octahedra. Therefore, this kind of geometrical isomerism is called facial isomerism. Face, it can form face, facial isomer, or also called the FAC, F-A-C, FAC isomer. What is a facial isomer? The similar ligands can form one face of the octahedra, or they occupy the adjacent corners for the triangular face. Okay. Now, in one more case, I will not write down the ligands in the triangular faces. I will write down randomly. Okay. So, we have got four corners to form square planar shape. Okay. Then, two more ligands. One is above the plane, other one is below the plane. So, what I will do now, I will write down the NH3 same position. Then, NH3 same position. One more, I will not write it here. I will write on the opposite side here. Okay. Like here. So, this will not form because of this nitrogen and this nitrogen is there in the same plane. Okay. So, it cannot form the face of the octahedra. Remaining, I'll write it here. Okay. NO2. Even these NO2 also cannot form face. It cannot form triangular face. Okay. Now, this is like a axis. This is the axis we have got. This is the axis. Okay. Axis. And around the axis, we have placed remaining ligand like NH3 and NH3. One is fixed. Okay. Amine is fixed. Remaining two are around this. Okay. Suppose this is a square book and you are passing one axis to that. And remaining two amines are around that axis. Okay. Around that axis like this. Around this axis. So, axis is also called as the meridian. Therefore, this isomer is called as the meridional isomer. Meridional isomer. Or also called as the mer isomer. Also called as the mer isomer. Clear? So, this is a special type, MA3B3. We can't call it as the specifically cis isomer and trans isomer. For cis isomer, two similar ligands should be on the opposite sides. Two similar ligands should be on the adjacent position. Here it is repeating three times. Therefore, we can't write specifically cis and trans. Therefore, we go for one more type under geometrical FAC isomer and the MER isomer. Okay, clear? That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe RD Chemistry, like and support. Thank you.